Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways. We, the daughters and sons of him, who build the valleys and plains, praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many are the blessings he bears to those who trust in his ways.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the memorial of Saint Teresa of Calcutta. We pray through her intercession that our love for God may grow, and as we continue to surrender ourselves to God, may the Lord bless us and keep us always with his many blessings. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, our God, that the Virgin Blessed Teresa of Calcutta, your faithful spouse, may stir up in our hearts the flame of divine love, which she inspired in other virgins to the enduring glory of your Church. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you considers himself wise in this age, let him become a fool, so as to become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the eyes of God. For it is written, God catches the wise in their own ruses. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain. So let no one boast about human beings, for everything belongs to you. Paul, or Apollos, or Cephas, or the world, or life, or death, or the present, or the future. All belong to you, and you to Christ, and Christ to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it.
To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it.
The Lord's are the earth and its fullness, the world and those who dwell in it. For he founded it upon the seas and established it upon the rivers.
To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it.
Who can ascend the mountain of the Lord, or who may stand in his holy place? He whose hands are sinless, whose heart is clean, who desires not what is vain.
To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it.
He shall receive a blessing from the Lord, a reward from God his Savior. Such is the race that seeks for him, that seeks the face of the God of Jacob.
To the Lord belongs the earth and all that fills it. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there along the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked all night and have caught nothing. But at your command, I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come to help them. They came and filled both boats, so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter said this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish they had made seized him and all those with him. And likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
There was this TV commercial of an instant noodle snack where a certain young boy, Magnifico, came home crying. Sabi niya po, galing siya sa tryouts ng basketball varsity. He was crying and he said to his mother, 12 lang ang napili sa tryouts. Pag pang 13th ako, practice ako ng practice. Bakit po, nanay? may uniform na ako, bakit po hindi ako napili? As if the child was telling his mother, I have given my all, and as one song would like to tell us as well, I did my best, but I guess my best wasn't good enough. Let us remember, my dear brothers and sisters, this beautiful encounter of Jesus and his soon-to-be apostles. They were disappointed. They were tired. Practice sila ng practice. Trabaho sila ng trabaho. They have worked all night. They gave all their best. But at the end of the day, at the end of a long work from the first watch of the night until the next morning, there was nothing. But here comes a son of a carpenter commanding fishermen. You see the great difference between the two. This son of the carpenter was commanding the fishermen to put into deep waters your nets for a catch. And you know, the response of Peter was moving. And this response of Peter, I do highly keep as my personal motto and even my inspiration. Parang sinabi po ni Simon Pedro kay Jesus, ginawa na po namin ang lahat. Buong gabi na ho kaming nagtatrabaho. Napagod na ho kami. Pero dahil sinabi mo, gagawin po namin. We will lower the nets for a catch. And after doing those, they caught great numbers. A miracle was just made true in front of their eyes. My dear brothers and sisters, when we do not anymore know what to do, let God. Let Him work. Let Him teach. Let Him teach you. Let Him teach us. Hindi po bulag ang Diyos sa mga parehas na linyahan natin sa buhay na ito. Practice ako ng practice. Trabaho po ako ng trabaho. Aral ako ng aral. Handa ako ng handa para sa pamilya ko. I always give my patience. I always give my time. But Lord, nasaan ang bunga? Anyari na, kumbaga tanongin po natin. Bakit parang wala pa din? Maybe we are just too much occupied with what we are doing and not anymore what God can do for our end and for our life. Maybe we have to let go of our pride, to let go of our ego, even the superiority complex that we all have inside us. Na parang sinasabi natin, kaya ko to, magagawa ko to. But we forget to listen to the Lord who may have better plans than ours, or maybe who may have bigger plans than ours. We celebrate and remember Saint Teresa of Calcutta today. And I know for a very fact, she prayed the same words. I have given my time, I have given my energy to feed, to be a neighbor to my brothers and sisters. But it seems that nothing is bearing fruit. But the Lord whispered to him, continue to put your nets into lower waters and you will find greater catch. Blessings, graces, and miracles will do happen when we surrender to the Lord like Peter. At your command, I will lower the nets. When like Peter, we say to Jesus, I have given my all, do your part. Wait for blessings, see miracles, witness graces, that will unfold in your life.
Please stand.
When our Savior says, "Come, follow me," He also calls us to follow His example of prayer, to throw wide a net of prayer for others. Let us pray in that generous way. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Father, the bishops, priests, and all who have been called to the fishers of men may have the courage and perseverance to cast their nets in deep waters. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That fishermen and all those who work at sea may have a harvest of God's bounty. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may have the courage to tell unbelievers the good news of our Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may touch the lives of the sick, the sorrowing, and those who suffer in mind and body. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died in Christ may receive their eternal reward. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions, as we also continue to lift up all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord of all people, through these prayers, gather together the lives of those seeking to follow your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May we receive, O Lord, we pray, the effects of this offering dedicated to you, so that we may be cleansed from all the earthly ways, and through the example of Blessed Teresa of Calcutta, be renewed by growth in heavenly life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrated themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original goodness, and bring it to experience on this earth the gifts you promise in the new world to come. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Teresa of Calcutta, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May the holy reception of the body and blood of your only begotten Son, O Lord, turn us away from the cares of this fleeting world, so that, following the example of Blessed Teresa of Calcutta, we may grow in sincere love for you on earth, and rejoice to behold you for eternity in heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.